So this is Meri.
She's a red panda.
Yep.
And I'm with Greg from the Connecticut Beardsley Zoo, the zoo director who has been so kind to bring us behind the scenes. This is so great.
Yeah, we're in our animal care center, and this is what you call our animal care center, our clinic. This is where we work with our animals here to make sure they are healthy and happy. And when any new animal comes into the zoo, we have to go through a series, through a quarantine period.
Okay.
Quarantine meaning that even though Meri came in from another zoo, we have a protocol that says making sure she's healthy, there's no issues going on before she is brought up into the main body of the zoo. So we want to make sure everything's cool, everything's wonderful. There's another thing here that we're going to be doing with her, which is another reason it's important for her being down here. Within another few weeks or so, she's going to be introduced to her potential mate, which is Rochan, which is our red panda, which is already here, our red panda that's already here. So again, this is part of what we call the SSP program, and this is basically a computer dating service.
And
Meri,
I hope they like each other.
I hope so. You really don't know. Meri has been picked, has been selected as a great good match for Rochan, and that is in a couple ways. One is through genetics. Their gene pools are far enough apart,
okay.
So where there's little inbreeding that we have to worry
right,
about, their inbreeding coefficients
right.
will be low. And second is that their ages are compatible. Meri came to us from the Brandywine Zoo in Delaware. Rochan was born in the Franklin Park Zoo in Boston. Right now, we're in the process of building a red panda habitat, which will be hopefully open up in the springtime.
Now, are they related to the giant pandas?
No, they're actually a subspecies. They're a species unto themselves. They were tried to be lumped into raccoons, but they don't really are into the raccoons, and they're not really in pandas. So they're really their own species. You can see as their tail has that raccoon-like tail. Their faces actually have a little raccoon look to them. But again, if we go to their genetic makeup and to their taxonomy, you'll find out these animals are not related to either one.
Where are they found? You know, where is their habitat?
Nepal, in the Himalayan mountains.
Wow.
They stay way up in the mountains. They love bamboo, just like giant pandas. However, their diet is varied. They will eat insects. They will eat fruit and vegetables. They will eat, you know, so they're not just fixated on bed like bamboo, but they like, they'll eat a lot of other things. They're more omnivorous than a panda, a giant panda is.
Wow, well, since...
So they do, and we grow our own bamboo here at the zoo. We're also building a new red panda habitat right now. The red panda habitat is going to be going down next to where our pronghorn antelope exhibit is right now. It's going to be a walk-in enclosure.
Fantastic.
So you're going to be able to walk inside, have nothing in front of you but the red pandas. The Nat family has been generous enough to give us the majority of the funding to name the exhibit for them. So the Nat family Red Panda Pavilion will be opening up in the spring. And we're really excited about that.
That's
very
cool.
They actually love the wintertime. So when we're building a new habitat for them, it's not the wintertime we have to worry about, it's the summertime.
Oh, how funny.
So it's opposite. We have to make sure that there's air conditioning for the red panda. We have to make sure there's misters to cool down the enclosure.
And you also mentioned her tail has really a purpose.
Well, as a tail,
right?
You can see how fluffy that tail is. It's giving you a good shot now. That tail, they'll wrap that somewhere. If it's very cold, they'll wrap that tail around them to keep themselves warm. And conversely, if they're really hot, that tail goes out and disseminates heat.
We are thrilled to be here, and we're sort of getting a little bit of a preview that nobody else is having.
That's exactly
but we
right.
encourage people to come to the Connecticut Beardsley Zoo. And for more information, Greg, where can people find you?
On our website at beardsleyzoo.org or on our Facebook page, Connecticut's Beardsley Zoo.
So come on down. You want to see this. And thanks for joining us. This has been Lauren's Crazy Pet Show.